In the earlier class, we discussed about the Boltzmann law, which was established as Ni is equals to A e raised to the power minus beta ui or e raised to the power minus alpha minus beta ui, whereas A is e raised to the power minus alpha, which was the constant. Now we have to find out this term, which is constant. For determine this, as we know that here total number of the particle in the system is constant. So we can say that n is equals to summation of ni, that is from the Boltzmann law we get n is equals to a e raised to the power minus beta ui. Put summation of e raised to the power minus beta ui as a, we get the result a is equals to n is equals to az, whereas z is the sum of total states and also known as partition function. So we can say that partition function is the function which denote total state of the system, whereas n a is equals to n by z. Using these two equations, we get the results ni is equals to n over z e raised to the power minus beta ui. So we get the value of a, which is n by z. The most important topics of the unit second are basic postulates of the statistical mechanics, which will used in three statistics: Bose-Einstein, Maxwell-Boltzmann and Fermi-Dirac. Next one is the phase space, which also important. We discussed earlier about it. We have to find out the size of the phase space and volume of the phase space. Or we can say that we determine what is the phase cell, actually what is the phase space cell. Next, occupation index and how can we determine the probability of the phase space cells individually and as a whole system. Next one is Stirling approximation, which is used in solving the derivations about the laws. Next is determination of the beta parameter and anentropy and probability. The anentropy is very important, in which we determine the value of the constant K, which is called Boltzmann constant, and its value gives us the results 1.38 into 10 to power minus 23 joule per Kelvin. This is the anentropy of the system. How anentropy relate with the thermodynamical probability? This question will arise in the exam. Next one is Boltzmann distribution law. We discuss in the last video and also in the class what is Boltzmann distribution law, how it can derive. It is very 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 important, in which we also determine the value of A. Now here we discuss about the value of other constant Z, which contain e raised to the power minus beta ui, which is not actually the constant. It is the function of the energy. As we know that ui is not constant. So we have to determine the value of beta. So to determine the value of beta, we have to consider a small quantity of heat d theta is given to the system of n molecules at a constant volume V. Due to supply of the heat energy, the molecules will move from cell to from cell of lower energy to the higher energy. As we know that when we supply the heat supply heat to the system, then it gain the heat and the molecules will start gaining the heat and they becomes from low energy level to high energy level. Consider Dn1, Dn2, Dn3 up to Dnk be the change in the number of the molecules in the cells 1, 2, 3, 4 up to K cells. Now, according to the thermodynamics, as we know that increase in the internal energy at constant volume of the system is given by d theta is equals to TdS or du is equals to TdS. We have to study about the anentropy is du is equals to du, ds is equals to du by t. Also, anentropy and probability relation, we have s is equals to k log of w. Here ds is percent, so we have to differentiate this equation. We can differentiate this ds is equals to k differentiation of log of w. As we know that the value of w here, or we can say that we have the value of log of w, we use it in the Boltzmann distribution law as ln w is equals to n log n minus summation of ni ln of n. So we get here ds is equals to k d n ln n minus summation of ni ln ni. After solving this, we get, as we know that n log of n gives us the result, differentiation of this term gives the result 0. As we know that here n is the total number of the particles in the system which always remains constant. So differentiation of the constant term gives us the result 0. So we get summation of ni log of ni, differentiate this term as u into v rule. Differentiate firstly first term dni log ni as it is plus ni as it is, differentiate the term log ni as 1 by ni into dni. So we get minus k summation of dni ln ni plus summation of dni. Again we can say that summation of dni gives the total number of the system, differentiation of the total number of the system, and as we know that total number of the molecules or total number of the particle in the system is constant, so we can say that dni will be 0. So we get the result ds is equals to minus k summation of ln, put the value of ni from the Boltzmann law, that is a e raised to the power minus beta ui. We get the result ln a e raised to the power minus beta ui dni, which gives the results, as we know that log of m into n gives the results log m plus log n. So we can say that here minus k summation of ln of a plus ln of e raised to the power minus beta ui into dni as it is. We can rewrite it as minus k ln of a summation of dni minus beta ui dni, which gives the results minus k ln of a summation of dni plus beta k summation of ui dni. As we know that summation of dni gives the result 0 and ui dni gives the results total energy of differentiation of the energy of the system, that is we can write it as du. So we get the results ds is equals to beta k du. Compare this equation with the thermodynamical law ds is equals to du by t. We get the results du by t is equals to beta k du, that is 1 by t is equals to beta k. So we get the value of beta as beta is equals to 1 by k t. Whereas k is the Boltzmann constant, we determine in this video, firstly. So we get the results. Beta is equals to 1 by KT. This results gives us the value of partition function, which is Z is equals to e raised to the power minus beta ui. That is, we can say that this is the summation of e raised to the power minus ui by kt. Put the value of beta as 1 by kt. So in the other large, which we will discuss later, we use the we directly use the value of beta as 1 by kt and the value of a as e raised to the power minus alpha. Also, we can find the value of k from this equation. Put the value of this, we get the results. The value of a becomes n, a is equals to ni by z, that is a is equals to ni by e raised to the power minus ui by kt. So the probability of the molecules possessing energy ui is given by probability of ui is equals to ni over n. Number of particle in the particular cell for which we have to find out the probability over the total number of the particle. So a e raised to the power minus ui by kt over n. Whereas a by n is a constant, we can put here this as c e raised to the power minus ui by kt. Now we have to determine the value of the constant C. As we know that the sum of the probability of all possible cells in a system is equals to 1. So summation of PUI is equals to 1. So from this equation, when we summation this, this is for the ith state, and we have to find for the total system. So we have to summation it. Summation of PUI is equals to C summation of e raised to the power minus ui by kt, which gives the result 1. So we can say that the value of c becomes 1 over summation of e raised to the power minus ui by kt. Putting the value of c in the equation, we get probability of ith state becomes e raised to the power minus ui by kt over summation of e raised to the power minus ui by kt. Whereas this is also known as Boltzmann partition function and can be denoted as Z. So from here we can say that Z indicate how the molecules or balls of a system are distributed among the various cells. This function can be used for calculating the various thermodynamic properties.